हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, टुडेज टॉपिक इज इंट्रावेनस इंडक्शन एजेंट प्रोपोफॉल. इट इज मोस्ट कॉमनली यूज्ड आईवी इंड्यूसिंग एजेंट. फर्स्ट वी विल सी द हिस्ट्री. द प्रोपोफॉल वाज इंट्रोड्यूस्ड इन 1970. नाउ इट बिकम मोस्ट वाइडली यूज्ड हिप्नोटिक एजेंट. द इनिशियल सॉल्यूशन ऑफ प्रोपोफॉल वाज रिलीज्ड इन 1977 इन क्रेमफोर ईएल. इट वाज विथड्रॉन बिकॉज ऑफ एनाफिलैक्टिक रिएक्शंस. इट वाज reinforced as a emulsion of soybean oil propofol mixture in water and relaunched in 1986. It is used for induction of anesthesia, maintenance of anesthesia and the sedation. Now we will see the physicochemical properties. It is one of group of alkyl phenol. The alkyl phenol are highly lipid soluble and insoluble in aqueous solution. The formulation commonly used is of 1% phenol, 10% soybean oil, 1.2% purified phospholipid as emulsifier, the 2.2% glycerol as a tonicity agent is added, sodium hydroxide is added to change the pH, and EDTA is used for its bacteriostatic activities. The pH of the propofol solution is 7. It appears slightly viscous. Milky white substance. Now we will see the pharmacokinetics. The propofol is oxidized to 1,4-diisopropylquinol in liver. The propofol and 1,4-diisopropylquinol are conjugated with glucuronic acid and then excreted in the kidney. Less than 1% of is excreted unchanged in urine. Less than 2% is excreted unchanged in feces. The metabolites of propofol are inactive. The clearance is more than 1.5 liter per minute. That means it exceeds hepatic blood flow. There is extrahepatic site of metabolism in lungs, and the renal metabolism is 30%. It is CYP3A4 inhibitor. The elimination half-life 4 to 7 hours, clearance 20 to 30 ml per kg per minute, volume of distribution at steady state 2 to 10 liter per kg. Now we will see the pharmacodynamics. The effects on central nervous system. The hypnotic action is mediated by enhancing GABA-induced chloride current. It occurs by binding two subunits to beta subunits of GABA receptor. It inhibits acetylcholine release in hippocampus in and prefrontal cortex. The alpha 2 adenoreceptor system also plays indirect role in sedative effect of propofol. It results in widespread inhibition of NMDA subtype of glutamate receptor through modulation of the sodium channels. The cells of well-being is related to increase in dopamine concentration in nucleus accumbens. The anti-emetic action is by decrease in serotonin levels in area prostrema. It suppresses seizure activity through GABA agonism, inhibition of NMDA receptor and modulation of calcium ion channels. It decreases intracranial pressure by 30 to 50%. It is associated with decrease in cerebral perfusion pressure. It decreases intraocular pressure by 30 to 40%. It is more effective in preventing intraocular pressure with succinylcholine and after endotracheal intubation. Now we will see the effect of propofol on cardiovascular system. It decreases arterial pressure during induction of anesthesia. It is associated with decreased in systemic vascular resistance by 15 to 25% with induction dose. Arterial and venous dilatation occurs. There is decrease in cardiac output, decrease in cardiac index and stroke volume index. The heart rate doesn't change significantly after induction dose as it may inhibit baroreflex. The vasodilatory and myocardial depressant effects of propofol are concentration dependent. Now we will see the effect on respiratory system. It produces dose-dependent depression of ventilation. The apnea occurs in 25 to 30% of the patients after induction dose of anesthesia. It depends on dose and speed of the injection. It causes bronchodilation in patients with COPD. The hypoxic pulmonary vasoconstriction is not inhibited. Propofol causes depression of upper airway reflexes. Now we will see the other effects of propofol. It doesn't enhance neuromuscular blockade, which is produced by neuromuscular blocking drugs. It will not trigger malignant hyperthermia. It does not affect corticosteroid system. The anaphylactoid reactions to propofol have been reported in patients with previous history of allergic response. The intralipid does not trigger histamine release. It inhibits phagocytosis and killing of Staphylococcus aureus and E. coli. The life-threatening infections after propofol are associated with its use. The open vials and syringes of propofol had a positive culture results. The intralipid solvent is excellent cultural medium. Disodium ethylbutyrate and metabisulfite added to retard the bacterial growth. The strict aseptic techniques must be followed. Its administration is associated with pancreatitis in older patients who receive propofol for longer duration. It is related to hypertriglyceridemia. Now we will see the dose. The induction dose for general anesthesia is 1 to 2.5 mg per kg. Dose is reduced with increasing age. The maintenance dose of propofol for general anesthesia is 50 to 150 microgram per kg per minute when it is combined with nitrous oxide or opiate. The sedation dose 25 to 75 microgram per kg per minute IV, and antiemetic action dose is 10 to 20 milligram per kg IV, can be repeated after 5 to 10 minutes. Now we will see the side effects. The side effect is pain on injection. It is common especially if given in small veins in the hand. Therefore, use larger veins. Avoid veins on the dorsum of hand. The pain can be reduced by addition of small doses of preservative-free lignocaine with propofol. Now we will see the propofol infusion syndrome. It is rare lethal syndrome of metabolic acidosis. It is associated with infusion of propofol at 4 mg per kg per hour or more when it is given for 48 hours or longer. It is observed in ICU. First it was described in children, then it is observed in critically ill patient. The clinical features. Number one, there is acute refractory bradycardia leading to asystole in presence of one of the following. There will be metabolic acidosis, the base deficit more than 10 millimole per liter, rhabdomyolysis, there may be hyperlipidemia, cardiac failure, hyperkalemia may occur, and the most common is lipemia. These sign symptoms are due to muscle injury and release of intracellular toxic contents. The predisposing factor is the genetic factors impairing fatty metabolism. Now we will see the induction indications. This propofol is a drug of choice in ambulatory daycare surgery as recovery is very rapid. It is used for conscious sedation and for ICU sedation. Now we will see the contraindications. Contraindications are egg and soya allergy. These are the relative contraindications. Patient with fixed cardiac output, that is severe aortic or mitral stenosis and cardiac tamponade, and patient with shock.